guys, I'm Aubrey. I own one of the biggest Latin dance companies here in Los Angeles, Empower Movement Dance Company. I'm a multi-world champion in Latin dance, and I travel around the world teaching salsa and bachata. Most importantly, I'm a STEEZY instructor. Things to keep in mind before we start. Bend your knees. This will help with moving your hips. And in salsa, we love to move our hips. That's what gives us the flavor or the sabor. If this is your first time using your hips, know it may feel a little awkward. That's totally natural, and you're probably doing it right. It may not feel that way, but you probably are. In salsa, we count 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. If you don't know what that means, consider watching this video.
1.
These counts will help you stay on your salsa timing. So when you start combining your steps with the music, you'll be on time. If everything I just said sounds confusing, don't worry. Let's just get moving, and you'll pick it up more and more as we go. Let's start with the salsa basic. This is the basic step of salsa. It's like a ballerina knowing their plie and a hip-hop dancer knowing their bounce. Step 1, left foot, step forward. Right foot, step in place. Left foot, step back together. Right foot, step back. Left foot, step in place. Right foot, back together. Things to think about. Remember when I said let's bend our knees and use our hips? Let's try adding some of that. Let's first try it with our knees bent. Now, let's add the hold on the 4 and the 8. Now, I'll show you the salsa basic with sabor. This might be a bit advanced for your first day, so you're welcome to try. Think of it like stretching goo or slime. You should feel a stretch from your shoulder to your hip bone, but do your best to keep your shoulders relaxed. I actually want to encourage you to practice the steps first, or take the beginner salsa program and come back to this video when you feel more comfortable. Here's a fun variation, the side salsa basic. We'll be doing the same steps, just in a different direction. Let's start with our left foot, and I'll show you with some sabor. Left foot steps left, right foot steps in place, left foot comes together. Now let's reverse it. Right foot to the right, left foot steps in place, right foot together. Now I'll show you with some sabor. The more you practice these steps, the more comfortable you'll be with moving your hips. Let's just keep learning so your body gets used to the basics of salsa. The second move is called the Suzy Q. This move consists of 3 steps with more hips and a twist. Step 1, twist to the right as we step with our left foot. Step back with the right and back on your left. Now, just reverse it. Twist to the left and step on your right. Step in place with your left, then step with your right. Now if you feel ready, let's add some sabor. If not, like I said before, come back to this video when you're ready to practice. Let me show you a variation by adding a drop. Same steps, but on the 3rd step, you'll drop by bending your knees. Put all of your weight on the front foot, then we lift and twist, and then repeat. Let's take a breather and learn a bit more about the culture of salsa dancing so we can fully understand that salsa is dance with a partner and without. But salsa dance is actually both of those together. Salsa is a form of social dance, meaning people often do it at a club, ballroom, or even dance socials. But honestly, you can dance salsa in the kitchen, living room, or even in your backyard. Fun fact, did you know that there are a ton of different salsa styles? The one you're learning right now was popularized in LA, and it's called Salsa on One, and known around the world as LA Style Salsa. So if you ever go to a salsa club, let the partner you're dancing with know that you're dancing Salsa on One or LA Style. Or else they might do one of the many other styles like Salsa on Two, Salsa Caleña, Timba, Salsahuela, and many more. All right, let's do this last move. This is called a front double cross. Now, there is a difference between a step and a tap. A tap, it's like you're tapping your foot. There's no weight on it. In a step, you add your weight. This step is a lot like the Suzy Q, but there's only one weight transfer or step. It will be a tap, tap, step. Step one, tap your left foot to the right corner, tap your left to the left corner, step on the left and with a slight twist. Reverse it and tap with your right to the left corner, tap with your right to the right corner, step on the right with that mini twist. But of course, we have to add some savoir. It'll be the same moves, but just adding a drop on the 3 and the 7. Salsa is a way of expression, and the more you learn, the more you'll be able to express yourself through movement and through music. So if these 3 moves are fun for you, you should definitely take the beginner salsa program on STEEZY by clicking the link in the description. You'll go more in depth into salsa shines, as well as understanding the foundation of salsa partner work. And who doesn't want to learn partner work? Make sure to subscribe to STEEZY's YouTube channel for more incredible dance content. And of course, download the STEEZY app to take more dance classes. We'll see you next time. Sabor. Sabor. To the right. Sabor. To the front. Sabor.